स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जयंती। टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू टेल अबाउट द ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी एंड डाइजेशन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन, ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर फॉर नीट एग्जाम बिकॉज दे विल आस्क टू क्वेश्चंस इन दिस चैप्टर। फूड इज द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म बिकॉज दे विल प्रोवाइड द एनर्जी एंड ऑल्सो द यूजफुल फॉर ग्रोथ एंड रिपेयर ऑफ द टिश्यूज। वॉटर, we drink water, it play metabolic activities in the body and prevents the dehydration. And vitamins, minerals, the vitamins and minerals both the micromolecules, they are directly absorbed into the cells. And next one is the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates, proteins, lipids. The carbohydrate, proteins and lipids are called as the macromolecules. These are not directly absorbed into the cells. So these are broken down by the helping of the enzymes. These are broken down by the helping of the enzymes, and after it is converted into the simple absorbable forms. Simple forms. The simple forms are called as the micromolecules. Macro means called as the complex molecules. Micro is called as the simple forms. So carbohydrates are broken down into the glucose, and proteins are broken down into the amino acids. And the lipids are broken down into the fatty acids, are also called as the glycerols. So these simple absorbable forms are absorbed into the cells. And what is the meaning of digestion? So digestion is called as the, it is a process, and in this process the complex food substances are converted into the simple absorbable forms. That is called as the digestion. This is also called as the hydrolysis. So the digestion is mainly consists of a two types of process. One is called as the mechanical process, and second one is called as the biochemical reactions or biochemical process. So digestion is called as the complex food substances are converted into simple absorbable forms is called as the digestion. So digestion is mainly have a two types of process are there. One is the mechanical process and second one is the biochemical process. What is the mechanical process? The mechanical means called as the, it is the chewing of the food materials by the helping of the teeth and mixing of the food materials by the helping of the tongue. So that is called as a mechanical process, because simple digestion by the helping of teeth and tongue. That is also called as a mastication. And second one is the biochemical process. That biochemical means enzymes, hormones. The enzymes and hormones are called as the chemical reactions. It plays a chemical reaction. So the biochemical, the enzymes and hormones are which are useful for digestion of the complex into the simple forms. The digestion means called as the breakdown. So the biochemical enzymes and hormones are called as which are useful for breakdown of the complex substances are into the simple absorbable forms. So these are called as the digestion. And next one is the digestive system. So the digestive system is mainly consists of two parts. One is called as the alimentary canal. And second one is called as the associated glands. Alimentary canal and also called as the associated glands. First one is called as the elementary canal. So the elementary canal, it is opens into the mouth and ends at the anus. The elementary canal. The elementary canal is the long tube in the man. This elementary canal is begins with the mouth and ends at the anus. In between mouth and anus, it have a different digestive organs are present. They are called as the buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, and large intestine, and finally anus. So these are called as the elementary canal. So first one is the mouth. The mouth is bordered by the movable lips, movable upper lip and also the lower lip. The lower lip is called as the labia. So in the mouth, it leads into the buccal cavity. So the buccal cavity is present in the mouth. A large space is present between the cheeks, jaws, teeth. So that space is called as the gap. That gap is also called as the vestibule. So the buccal cavity is consists of a palate. The palate is, it is separates the nasal chambers, dorsal nasal chambers and ventral, oral cavity. So that is called as the palate. The palate is separates the nasal chambers and also the ventral oral cavity, which are useful for the chewing of the food materials and breathing of the air. And palate is mainly two types. One is called as the hard palate. The hard palate is, this one is called as the hard palate. The hard palate is, it is called as the bony palate, and this hard palate is lined by the palatine rugae. And next, posteriorly is called as the anterior palate is called as the hard palate, which is lined by the palatine rugae, and posterior palate is called as the soft palate. That soft palate is hangs down into the pharynx. That is called as the soft palate, and this soft palate is called as the ulva. And next one is the, in the buccal cavity, it mainly have a jawbones, four sets of the jawbones and also the tongue. So next one is the, teeth. So teeth are, these are mainly present at the ectomesodermal in origin. These teeth are in the human being embedded in the socket of the jawbone. So that type of dentition is called as the thecodent type of dentition. The teeth are present at the socket of the jawbone. That type of dentition is called as a thecodent type of dentition. And hence, majority of the human being and begins with the two sets of the teeth. In the human being lifetime, it have a two sets of the teeth, that is called as the diphodent dentition. Diphodent type of dentition. And these diphodent dentition, it mainly have a different types of the teeth. Mainly have a different types of the teeth. That type of dentition is called as the heterodont type of dentition. Basically, mainly it have human being have three types of the dentitions. Thecodont dentitions, diphodont dentition and heterodont type of dentition. Thecodont means called as the teeth are embedded in the socket of the jawbone is called as the thecodont. And diphodont means it have in the human lifetime it have a two sets of the teeth called as the diphodont. So these diphodont mainly two types. One is called as the milk teeth. That is also called as the deciduous teeth. Deciduous teeth. And next one is called as the permanent teeth. And next one is the different types of the dentitions. So in the human being mainly have a four sets of the teeth. It mainly have a four types of teeth. Four types of teeth. These are called as the incisors and canines and premolars and molars. Four types of teeth are present in the human being, so that's why they are called as the heterodont type of dentitions. Incisors, these incisors are called as the chisel shape. Incisors are called as the chisel shape and canines are called as the and these incisors are mainly useful for the cutting of the food materials. It mainly have a in the upper jaw consists of a four teeth and the lower jaw it have a four teeth. And next one is the canines. These canines are called as the dagger teeth. Dagger teeth, which are useful for the tearing of the food material. In the upper jaw have a two teeth and lower jaw have a two teeth. And premolars, the premolars are called as the check teeth, which are useful for the grinding of the food material. In the upper jaw have a four teeth and lower jaw have a four teeth. And next one is the molars. The molars are, these are also called as the check teeth. In the upper jaw have a six teeth and lower jaw have a six teeth. So the adult dental formula called as the 2123 by 2123 into 2 called as the 32. So the adult dental formula 2123 by 2123 is called as the 32 teeth. So these are called as the thecodont, diphodont and heterodont type of dentitions. In the milk dental formula 2102 by 2102 into 2 called as the 20 teeth. So the premolars are absent in the milk teeth. So these are called as the teeth. And structure of teeth. Structure of tooth. So tooth are mainly have three parts. Structure of tooth. Tooth have mainly have three parts. One is called as the crown and second one is called as the neck. And third one is called as the root. It mainly have three parts. So, first one is called as the crown. Crown is called as the exposed part. And neck is called as the middle part. And root is called as the innermost embedded in the socket of the jawbone. So, first one is called as the crown. And second one, neck. And third one is the root. So, The bulk of the tooth is formed in the hard material is called as the dentine. The bulk of the tooth is embedded in the hard material is called as the dentine. These dentine is secretes the odontoblast. So that odontoblast means called as the dentine produces cells are called as the odontoblast. So these are called as the dentine. So the dentine is secretes the odontoblast. The odontoblast means called as the it is produce the cells of the teeth called as the odontoblast. And these dentine is present in the mesodermaline origin. And next one is the crown. The crown is covered by the enamel. The crown is covered by the enamel. The crown is covered by the enamel. So the enamel is called as the hardest substance in the human body is called as the enamel. So these enamel is also secretes the amyoblast. The enamel is also secretes the amyoblast. So these amyoblasts means called as the epidermal cells of it secretes the enamel of the tooth is called as the amyoblast. So students, they will ask like this question in a NEET exam, what is the hardest substance in the human body? Options: dentine, bone and enamel, all the above. So the hardest substance in the human body is called as the enamel. And next, in the a small cavity is present inside the tooth is called as the pulp cavity. So this is called as the cavity. A small cavity is present inside the tooth is called as the cavity, that is called as the pulp cavity. So these pulp cavities which is filled with the pulp, and in this pulp it mainly have a blood vessels and also the lymphatic vessels, and it is also have a nerves. And these pulp cavity is covered by the dentine of the root is covered by the cementum. So these dentine of the root is covered by the cementum. And the root is fixed in the socket of the jawbone and by the cementum. The root is fixed in the socket of the jawbone by the cementum. And the basal part of the tooth is covered by the basal part of the tooth is covered by the gums. The gums are also called as the gingiva. The root is fixed in the socket of the jawbone by the cementum and also called as the periodontal membrane. So this is called as the periodontal membrane. So this is called as the tooth. So students, tooth is mainly have three parts. One is called as the crown, and second one is called as the neck, and third one is called as the root. So the dentine is the second hardest substance in the human body is called as the dentine. And this dentine is covered by the cementum, and the dentine is covers the exposed part is called as the enamel. So these enamel is secretes the amyoblast. So these amyoblast is called as the epidermal cells. It secretes the enamel, And the next one is the dentine. The dentine is secretes the odontoblast. So these odontoblast means called as the, it is the producing the cells of the tooth is called as the dentine. And next one is the root. The root is covered by the cementum and also called as the periodontal membrane. So these root is fixed into the socket of the jawbone by the helping of the periodontal membrane and also called as the cementum. And next, the basal part of the tooth is covered by the gums called as the gingiva. And students, next one is the tongue. So tongue is called as the, it is a freely movable organ. Tongue is called as the, it is called as the freely movable organ called as the tongue. And this tongue, it is a muscular organ attached to the floor of the oral cavity. It is attached to the floor of the oral cavity is called as the tongue. And this tongue is that this tongue is attached to the floor of the oral cavity by the fold is called as the frenulum. By the fold is called as the frenulum. So students, they will ask like this question in a NEET exam. It is very very important. Freely movable tongue is attached to the oral cavity by called as the frenulum. Freely movable tongue is attached to the oral cavity is called as the frenulum. And these tongue have, the upper surface of the tongue have a smaller projections that are called as the upper surface of the tongue have a smaller projections that is called as the papillae. So these some of the papillae are also called as the taste buds. Some of the papillae are also called as the taste buds. And these taste buds are mainly three types. One is called as the fungiform. Second one is called as the filiform. And third one is called as the circumvallate papillae. So first one is called as the fungiform. The fungiform is present at the tip of the tongue and also called as the surface of the tongue. So these fungiform, it is look like a mushroom shaped. The fungiform is look like a mushroom shape elevated. Mushroom shaped elevated form called as the fungiform. And next one is the filiform. This filiform is called present at the surface of entire the surface of the tongue. And this filiform is look like a point or also called as a thread like structure is called as the filiform. And next one is the circumvallate papillae. The circumvallate papillae is present at the base, posterior base of the tongue. It is look like a V shape. It will look like a V shape called as the circumvallate papillae. And these tongue is which are useful for the detection of the taste. Basically, it detect the salt, sweet, and sour, and also called as the bitter. It is detect the salt, sweet, and sour, and bitter taste. Sweet, salt. It is detect the tip, and also called as the sides. Sweet taste. It is detected by the tip of the tongue. Sour taste. It is detected by the sides or base of the tongue. And bitter taste, it is identified by the helping of the base of the tongue is called as the sour taste. So it mainly have three papillae are present, fungiform, filiform and circumvallate papillae. And another papillae, fourth papillae is also present, that is called as the foliate papillae. So these foliate papillae is present at the lateral margin of the tongue near to the base. These are called as the foliate papillae. It is present at the lateral margin of the tongue near to the base of the circumvallate papillae or base of the tongue. That is called as the tongue. And these tongues which are useful for the detection of the taste. And the second one is the speaking. And it is useful for the mixing of food materials with saliva. Which are useful for mixing of the food material with saliva. And next one is the, and it is also useful for deglutition. The deglutition is called as the swallowing of the food materials. So these are swallowing of the food materials, swallowing of the water, swallowing of the saliva, that is called as the deglutition. So these are called as the tongue. Pharynx is the common passage of the food and air. The pharynx is the common passage of the food and air. It is the oral cavity is leads into the pharynx, and it is a short and which serves as the common passage of the food and air. Students, they will ask like this question in your NEET exam. Very, very important. What is the common passage of the food and air in the human body? That is called as the pharynx. And it is divided into mainly three parts. One is called as the nasopharynx. And second one is called as the oropharynx. And third one is called as the laryngopharynx. Laryngopharynx is called as the pharynx. So, first one is the nasopharynx. The nasopharynx is lies above the soft palate. The nasopharynx is lies above the soft palate is called as the nasopharynx. Second one is called as the oropharynx. It is the middle part of the pharynx is called as the oropharynx. Third one is called as the laryngopharynx. So the laryngopharynx is called as the lower part. Is called as the pharynx. So the trachea is the laryngopharynx. So esophagus and trachea both are open into the laryngopharynx. Esophagus and also the trachea both are open into the laryngopharynx. So the trachea and laryngopharynx are through the glottis. The trachea opens into the laryngopharynx and through the glottis. So these glottis is covered by a thin flap-like structure, cartilaginous flap-like structure, that is called as the epiglottis. A thin cartilaginous flap-like structure is called as the epiglottis, which is useful for the prevent the entry of the food into the glottis, is called as the epiglottis. Students, they will ask like this question in your NEET exam. It is very, very important for NEET. Entry of the food is into the trachea is prevented by the helping of the epiglottis. Entry of the food into the trachea is prevented by the epiglottis. And next one is the pharynx which are possessed the voluntary muscles there to assist the swallowing of the food materials and swallowing. And these pharynx, it have a tonsils. It have a lymphoid, mucosa associated lymphoid tissue is called as the tonsils. The tonsils are mainly three types. One is called as the pharyngeal tonsils. and second one is called as the palate and tonsil, and third one is the lingual tonsils. First one is the pharyngeal tonsils. So the pharyngeal tonsil is present at the a mass of lymphoid tissue is present at the base of the present at the is the fundic portion. The fundic portion, it is the main body, and these fundic portion is mainly have three types of the cells: neck cells, and second one is the peptic cells, and third one is called as the oxyntic cells, are also called as the parietal cells. And the neck cells are secretes the mucus, which is useful for the protection of the stomach. And the next one is the peptic cells. These are secretes the proteolytic enzymes. And third one is the oxyntic cells. The oxyntic cells are secretes the HCL and also called as the castral intrinsic factor. Castral intrinsic factor. They are called secreted by the oxyntic cells. The castral intrinsic factor, which are useful for the absorption of the vitamin B12. So students, they will ask like this question in your NEET exam. It is very, very important. Substance essential for the absorption of the vitamin B12 by the helping of castral intrinsic factor. I will ask again. Substance essential for the absorption of vitamin B12 is by the helping of castral intrinsic factor. And the next one is the phyloric portion. So the phyloric portion, it mainly secretes the gastric hormone. Is called as the phyloric portion. And these phyloric portion, it mainly have a phyloric sphincter muscle. The phyloric sphincter muscle is present at the phyloric region because it is open into the small intestine. So the food is passing, and after digestion of the food in the stomach, it is passing into the small intestine by the helping of the phyloric sphincter muscle. And next one is the small intestine. The duodenum is look like, it is the proximal part, and it is look like a U-like structure. And this duodenum is made up of a smooth muscle. And this duodenum secretes the digestive secretion. Is called as the duodenum. And next one is the jejunum. The jejunum is called as the middle part of the small intestine. It mainly have 1 meter long. And the major part of the digestion is completed in the jejunum. And next one is the ileum. The ileum is called as the distal part. It mainly have 2 meters length, is called as the ileum. The ileum, finally the food is transferred into the ileum. After digestion, the food is transferred into the large intestine. The undigested food is transferred into the large intestine by the helping of the ileocecal valve. After digestion, the undigested part is transferred into the large intestine by the helping of the ileocecal valve. So, the duodenum is mainly play a major important role in the digestion because the hepatopancreatic duct is open into the duodenum part. The hepatopancreatic duct is transfer the hepatopancreatic juice into the small intestine by the helping of the sphincter of the ODE. By the helping of sphincter of ODE. The hepatopancreatic duct is open into the duodenum by the helping of the sphincter of the ODE. And next one is the large intestine. Large intestine. The large intestine is, it mainly 1.5 meters long and 6.5 in diameter. And this large intestine, it mainly have three parts. One is called as the cecum. The large intestine is mainly have a three parts. One is called as the cecum. Second one is the colon. And third one is the rectum. First one, cecum. The cecum is called as a small sac-like structure, sac-like tube. The ileocecum sphincter muscle is open into the, opens the undigested waste into the cecum region, and some of the symbiotic bacteria or microorganisms are present in the cecum region. So that symbiotic microorganisms are present in the cecum, so that cecum is a host for the microorganisms. And next, a small finger like projection is arises from the cecum is called as the vermiform appendix. So these are also called as the abdominal tonsil. These are also called as the vestigial organ in the body is called as the vermiform appendix. And next one is the colon. The colon is mainly three regions, divided to the three regions. One is called as the ascending colon and transverse colon. And second one is called as the descending colon. Ascending colon, transverse colon, and also called as the descending colon. A longitudinal muscles, of thick end of, muscularis of thick end of the large intestine is called as the Tanea coli. Tanea coli. So these bands are a three conspicuous bands are formed to the hostra. Outpouch is called as the hostra, and it leads into the rectum. And next one is the rectum. The rectum, which are useful for the, it is the storage of the feces for some time into the rectum, and finally the rectum is leads into the anal canal. Finally it leads into the anal canal. Next one is the anal canal. The anal canal, it mainly have 2 to 3 centimeters. Long, called as the anal canal. And after digestion, the undigested waste is transferred into the rectum. It is useful for the storage of the feces, for some time in rectum. And after it is transferred into the anal canal, after it is transferred to the outside, So the anal canal have 2 to 3 centimeters long and which are opened by the mainly two types of the sphincter muscle. One is called as the intrinsic anal sphincter muscle and also the extrinsic anal sphincter muscle. The intrinsic anal sphincter muscle is the involuntary anal sphincter muscle that is made up of a smooth muscle. And extrinsic anal sphincter muscle is called as the voluntary sphincter muscle. It is made up of a stripped muscle. It receives the neural plexus from the brain, and after the extrinsic anal sphincter muscle is open to the outside. And the large intestine is, it is no activity, there is no significant digestion activity in the large intestine. It is only concerned with the absorption of the some water and minerals and also the certain drugs. There is no activity of the digestion in the large intestine. It is only some absorption of the drugs and also the minerals. And certain water. It is only absorbed in the large intestine. And it secretes the mucus, these large intestine secretes the mucus, which is useful for the lubricating and keeping and passing of the undigested particles together. The lubricating it passing to the exterior by the helping of the mucus. So these are called as the digestive system.